something.
Come forward. You have nothing to fear here. I am Knight Paladin Gelibor. Welcome to the Great Chantry of Auriel.
Is he a freaking wood elf? Snow elf.
Auriel, Auriel, Halkosh, Akatosh, so many different names for the sovereign of the snow elves. Snow Elf. The name Falmer usually holds a negative meaning to most travelers. Those twisted creatures you call Falmer, I call the Betrayed. Of course, you're here for Auriel's bow. Why else would you be here? I can help you get it, but first, I must have your assistance. For the thousands of years I've served as the Chantry's Sentinel, there hasn't been a single visitor here for any other reason. They request Auriel's bow, and I request their assistance. It's been repeated so many times, I can't imagine it any other way. I need you to kill Archcurate Werther, my brother. The kinship between us is gone. I don't understand what he's become, but he's no longer the brother I once knew. It was the Betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen. They swept into the Chantry without warning, and began killing everyone without pause. The Chantry was a place of peaceful worship. I led a small group of paladins, but we were no match for the Betrayed's sheer numbers. They slaughtered everyone, and stormed the inner sanctum where I believe they corrupted Werther. He's alive. I've seen him, but something's wrong. He never looks as though he's in pain or under duress. He just stands there and watches, as though waiting. Leaving the Wayshrines unguarded would be violating my sacred duty as a Knight Paladin of Auriel. And an assault on the Betrayed guarding the Inner Sanctum would only end with my death. Yes, let me show you. This structure is known as a way shrine. They were used for meditation and for transport when the Chantry was a place of enlightenment. Prelates of these shrines were charged with teaching the mantras of Auriel to our initiates.
What's that basin in the center signify?
Once the initiate completed his mantras, he'd dip a ceremonial ewer in the basin at the way shrine's center and proceed to the next way shrine.
So these initiates had to lug around a heavy pitcher of water. Marvelous. How long would they have to do that?
Well, once the initiate's enlightenment was complete, he'd bring the ewer to the Chantry's inner sanctum. Pouring the contents of the ewer into the sacred basin of the sanctum would allow him to enter for an audience with the Arch-Curate himself.
All that just to end up dumping it out? Makes no sense to me.
It's symbolic. I don't expect you to understand.
So, let's get this straight. We need to do all that nonsense to get into the temple so we can kill your brother and live on his bones.
I know how it all sounds. But if there was another way, I'd have done it long ago. The only way to get to my brother is by following in the initiate's footsteps and traveling from way shrine to way shrine, just as they did. The first lay at the end of Darkfall Passage, a cavern that represents the absence of enlightenment. There are five in total, spread far apart across the Chantry. Caves? Oh no. The Chantry encompasses far more than a few caves, as you'll soon discover. But before I send you on your way, you'll need the initiate's ewer. Once you've located a way shrine, there'll be a spectral prelate tending to it. They will allow you to draw the waters from the shrine's basin, as if you've been enlightened. This may be the last time we're able to converse. If you have any questions before you leave, I suggest you ask them. Otherwise, all I can do now is grant you my hopes for a safe journey. Questions? I expected as much. We were once a wealthy and prosperous society that occupied a portion of Skyrim. Unfortunately, we were constantly at war with the Nords, who claimed the land as their ancestral home. In a manner of speaking, we had always maintained an uneasy alliance with the underground-dwelling dwarves, and when faced with extinction, we turned to them for help. Surprisingly, they agreed to protect us, but demanded a terrible price: the blinding of our race. There were splinter groups that resisted the agreement, and even some that sought alternate alliances. But when it was all said and done, those elves were either slaughtered, vanished, or gave up and took the dwarves' bargain. I've often asked myself that very same question. The blinding of my race was supposedly accomplished with a toxin, certainly not enough to devolve them into the sad and twisted beings they've become. The Chantry is quite isolated, so it took some time for word of the dwarves' offer to reach us here. By the time the compact had been completed, it was too late for us to even attempt to intervene. Correct. We only numbered perhaps 100 at the time, so our presence remained a secret to the dwarves and the Nords. Ironically, our undoing came at the hands of our own people. Yes. They swarmed the Chantry in vast numbers until we were completely overrun. We never really stood a chance. I assume that the Arch-Curate was corrupted by them when they found a way to breach the inner sanctum. Vertha and myself are the only two snow elves that remain. This is, or was, the epicenter of our religion. Most of the snow elf people worshipped Auriel. The Chantry was constructed near the beginning of the First Era to provide a retreat for those that wished to become enlightened. Our empire had temples to some of the other deities. Trinimac, Cerebane, Yefray, and Finister rounded out the rest. But those temples paled in comparison to the glory of the Chantry and its way shrines. Oh yes, they were an important part of the process here. They represented the steps the initiates took on the path to total enlightenment. Sadly, the magic used to construct these wonders were lost long before I arrived here. They're ghosts of the snow elf priests that tended the way shrines, before being slaughtered by the Betrayed. Through the grace of Auriel, they were restored to their spectral form to enable them to continue their duties. I'm afraid in their current form, they still believe the Chantry to be an active center of worship. They won't respond to you in any way other than believing that you're an initiate and you're undertaking the journey to the inner sanctum. May Auriel watch over you.
Soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now. Where'd you come from?
Kree!
Where'd you come from? Where'd you come from? Where'd you come from? Thank you. your eyes open. Where'd you come from? That'll teach you. Who's there? I knew I heard something.
Full HP, really?
Where'd you come from? This better not be all the things you just can't be bothered with. You come from.
Please!
Be careful here. Whatever's on the other side of this, Fulma wanted to keep it there. Where'd you come from? This is the kind of thing I've been wanting to see. Makes everything else worth it. That's another way shrine up there. Here we go.
Welcome, Initiate. This is the Way Shrine of Illumination. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it light your path as you seek tranquility within the inner sanctum.